Hi there. Welcome to the fifth problem in the Problem Corner playlist in the Genesis YouTube channel. Today, we will discuss a well-known problem, but we'll be exploring some ideas that will make the solution much easier than the standard method. A key step in becoming good at problem solving is not to solve a million problems, but to solve a good number of well-designed problems and try to understand various facets of the situation. The method that we will discuss today is a lesson in lateral thinking and how sometimes when solving physics problems, we tend to fall into a rut and stop thinking beyond the usual ways of solving the problem. So without further ado, let us see the problem. The problem statement is, a small stone is thrown from the ground at some angle to the horizontal so as to graze the top four corners of a regular hexagon in the same vertical plane as the path of the stone. If the side length of the hexagon is A, find the range of the projectile. Now, this is quite a well-known problem and it is often touted as an Olympiad-level problem. But as you will see, that the standard solution involves no unique lines of thought and no features which stand out. So, first we'll look at the standard way of solving this question. Now, one key to solving this problem is using the equation of path of a projectile. For a projectile projected with speed u at an angle theta with the horizontal, the equation of path with origin selected at the projection point is y is equal to x tan theta minus gx square by 2u square cos square theta. Or this can also be written as y is equal to x tan theta into 1 minus x by r, where r is the horizontal range of the projectile. These are fairly standard results known to all students. Coming back to our problem, let the stone be thrown with a velocity u vector at an angle theta with the horizontal at P and let it fall down at Q. What we want is the length PQ, which we denote as R. Now, one of the calculation savers in our situation is to choose the origin wisely. The most apt choice of the origin is the vertex B, as it makes the coordinates of the points C, D and E very easy to write. The coordinates of these points with B as origin are shown. Calculating the coordinates is a very easy calculation which all of you will be able to do. You can pause the video and just work it out. Now, for writing the equation of path in the standard form, we need the velocity and projection angle at the origin, which is the point B, but we don't know that. So let us assume that at B, the velocity of the particle is v vector directed at an angle alpha to the horizontal. One thing to note at this point, we have introduced four variables, u, theta, v, alpha, and so we need four equations. Why I'm not including capital R as a variable is because once I know u and theta, I can find R. So we need four equations. We have four variables and we need four equations. As a rule of thumb, while solving problems, always keep track of the number of variables that you're introducing. That always keeps you in the know of how many equations you need. Now we can see that the upper projectile, this one, is a standard projectile with initial speed v thrown at an angle alpha and it has a range of 2a. The distance BE is 2a. I'll first use the form y is equal to x tan theta into 1 minus x by r. Now, as the point C lies on this path, its coordinate should satisfy this point and substituting the coordinates of C, we get root 3a by 2 is equal to a by 2 tan alpha into 1 minus a by 4a. This will immediately give you tan alpha. I suggest you calculate the value of tan alpha and keep it as a reference for yourself. Now, as the range of the upper projectile is 2a, we can write the formula for range as 2a is equal to v square sine 2 alpha by 2g. Since we know alpha, this will immediately give us v. I also suggest that you find the value of v from here and keep it as a reference. So we have found out v and alpha. All that we need to do now is find u and theta from which we can find the range capital R. To do this, we first use the fact that the horizontal velocity of a projectile remains constant and therefore we have u cos theta equals v cos alpha. Further, we can conserve energy between the points P and B and we get half mu square is equal to half mv square plus mg into root 3a by 2. Now we already know v and alpha. From these two equations now, we can find u and theta. I'll leave the solving up to you. It is not difficult to do, but it requires some patience with the manipulations. On finding u and theta, you can use r is equal to u square sine 2 theta by g to get the answer as r is equal to root under 7a. So far, so good. all regular standard stuff that we use in the solution of physics problems. No bells and whistles concept-wise, but not that simple either. There is quite a lot of simplification required, and it is indeed quite tedious. Now, we turn to a non-standard solution and see how thinking differently can reduce the length of the solution and the work required drastically. So, the non-standard solution goes like this. The path of the projectile is a parabola, isn't it? And so, if we take the origin at the topmost point, like this, the equation has the form y is equal to minus kx square, where k is a positive constant. This is a standard result known to us. Let this vertical distance be d, then the coordinates of the points d, e and q are shown. You can easily write this down. As these points lie on the curve y is equal to minus kx square, substituting the coordinates of these points in the equation y is equal to minus kx square gives me three very simple relations. Now all of you can solve these three equations in just under 2 minutes to get capital R is equal to root under 7a. This solution will be much faster, calculations will be much easier, and so do you see how a simple change of origin simplified this problem to a maths problem rather than a physics one? You can argue that this approach strips off the physical aspects of the problem. However, it gets the job done, doesn't it? This is just one example of how changing our way of looking at a situation can simplify our solutions to a huge extent. We will see this many times in the upcoming videos in the Problem Corner playlist. I hope you have enjoyed this unique solution to the problem. For more such intriguing problems and approaches to problem solving, keep watching the Genesis YouTube channel. Serious JEE aspirants may also want to check the Solutions to JEE 2020 playlist. And if you like the work, like, subscribe, and share widely amongst your friends so that maximum students can benefit from this. Till the next problem, stay safe and stay healthy, you all.